In this class, we will discuss why respiration is called as amphibolic pathway. So the respiratory pathway is also called as amphibolic pathway because, now for example, imagine if the cell requires energy, the carbohydrates are broken down to release glucose. So carbohydrates are the common respiratory substrates. So they break down to release glucose. The glucose enters into glycolysis pathway, where glucose is converted into finally pyruvic acid. Now we know that pyruvic acid enters into the link reaction of the aerobic respiration, if you can remember. And after the link reaction, acetyl-CoA is produced. This acetyl-CoA enters into the Krebs cycle, where the carbon is going to break, and what is released is CO2 and water is released. So this we have learnt in the aerobic respiration pathway. So during glycolysis, first glucose converts into pyruvic acid. So during link reaction, pyruvic acid converts into acetyl-CoA, and this acetyl-CoA enters into the Krebs cycle. Now here this molecule is completely broken down, releasing all the carbons. So now what is released is lots of energy is released, and also reduced coenzymes are also released. So this ATP, directly ATP are produced, and the reduced coenzymes, they enter into the electron transport chain and producing lot of ATPs. So that we have already completed the aerobic respiration pathway. Now, if there is no carbohydrates, imagine there is no carbohydrate in the cell, then who can be acting as a respiratory substrate? Imagine cell needs energy. So in that case, proteins breaks, fats also break. So carbohydrates lenappudu, fats and proteins, they act as respiratory substrates. So second would be the fats. Fats, they break down to release fatty acids and glycerol. So these fatty acids, they undergo a beta oxidation and converts into acetyl-CoA, and that's how they enter into the respiratory pathway. So acetyl-CoA, as we know, then it enters into the Krebs cycle. So atla respiratory pathway ki connect avutai. So fats break down to fatty acids and glycerol. Fats, how they enter into the respiratory pathway? So ikkada link ostadi. So fatty acids, first they undergo beta oxidation, convert into acetyl-CoA and enter into the Krebs cycle. That is how they break and release energy, ATP. Now how does this glycerol enter the respiratory chain? So glycerol undergoes phosphorylation and oxidation. So after these two processes, it converts into glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate. Now this glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate is an intermediate in glycolysis, if you can remember. So this G3P later converts into pyruvic acid, acetyl-CoA and then Krebs cycle. So this connection point of glycerol would be from G3P of glycolysis onwards. So from here it is continuing. So atla they enter into respiratory pathway and they break down. Right. Now next, imagine if there is fats are also not present in the cell. Right. Now what is going to happen? So the proteins can also act as respiratory substrates. So right, proteins, they break down to release amino acids. These amino acids undergo deamination. These amino acids amino group ni teesese normal organic acids form aithe. So amino acids undergo deamination process and convert into either pyruvic acid. And if they convert into pyruvic acid, so here is the link of the respiratory. Ikkadiki connect avutai respiratory pathway ki. So pyruvic acid then enters, converts into acetyl-CoA, and the next process is Krebs cycle, which we know. Or the amino acids can undergo deamination and form any of the organic acids. pyruvic acid e avalan ledu, any of the organic acids ka, like ipudu alpha ketoglutaric acid, oxaloacetic acid, atla there are many different type of acids present. So it may convert into any of these organic acids and they enter into the Krebs cycle. So that is how they connect to the respiratory pathway. So what we understood is, this is all the catabolic process. So the carbohydrates, they break down to release glucose, and glucose enters into respiratory pathway to release energy. So when carbohydrates are not present, fats may break. Breaking is what? Catabolic process. Proteins may break and they enter into the respiratory pathway. They connect in different, you know, methods, as I told you. So atla, finally they liberate energy. So this is all what? It's a catabolic process. Catabolism means breaking of the molecules. So carbohydrates break, or fats are breaking, or proteins are breaking. It's catabolic process to liberate energy. Right. But imagine in a cell, a situation, a fatty acids production is needed. Cell lo, imagine there is a demand for fatty acids. Mar appudu etla avutadi? So now let's understand a situation. Fatty acid scarcity is there in the cell. So what happens is, the acetyl-CoA, this acetyl-CoA is undergoing reduction process and converts into fatty acids. So acetyl-CoA converts into fatty acids. Atla fatty acids production can be observed. Ante acetyl-CoA coming out from the respiratory pathway and then converts into fatty acids. It's one mechanism, right? Now imagine a situation, fats scarcity is there in the cell. Fats takku unnai cell lopala. So in that case, what happens is, listen carefully, the G3P converts into glycerol. G3P undergoes dephosphorylation and reduction and converts into glycerol. The acetyl-CoA converts into fatty acids. So these, they come out from the respiratory pathway. G3P converts into glycerol. Acetyl-CoA converts into fatty acids. Fatty acids combine with glycerol to form what? Fats. So this is what anabolic process. Small molecules combine to form large molecule is anabolic process. Now imagine the same concept is kunam. Like imagine a protein amount is less in the cell. So now what happens is, this pyruvic acid is undergoing amination. Amination and converts into amino acid. These amino acids will be used for the synthesis of protein. Atlane, Krebs cycle lo unnatuvanti organic acids, they undergo amination process, addition of amine, and then they convert into amino acids, and then they produce what? Amino acids combine to form what? Proteins. And so this is what? This process is anabolic process. It is an anabolic process. So glycerol plus fatty acids producing fats is anabolic process. Small molecules combine to form large molecule. Similarly, amino acids combine to form proteins is what? Anabolic process. And depending upon the situation, demand in the cell, either catabolic process will take place or anabolic process will take place. So since the respiratory pathway is involved in both catabolic and also anabolic, depending upon the demand in the cell, that is why the respiratory pathway is considered as amphibolic pathway. Amphi and both catabolic and anabolic pathway may take place depending upon the demand in the cell. So that is why it is considered as amphibolic pathway.